So welcome to the fourth video where I solve chemical process technology questions from GATE. So in this video we are also going to solve some questions. So let's get directly into it. So this question asks that the prilling tower is found in the flow sheet for the manufacturing of. The answer is directly urea. No need to read the other options. So the answer is prilling tower is found in the flow sheet of urea. So this question asks the proper arrangement of the petroleum fractions in the order of their boiling point is. So the answer to this is lubricating oil, diesel, then petrol, then LPG. This is the correct option. So lubricating oil has the highest boiling point, then diesel, then petrol, and the last is the LPG. So always remember that lubricating oil, this will have the highest boiling point. Then what we will have? Then we will have the petrol. And last what we will have is the LPG. This has the least boiling point, this has the highest boiling point. So make note of this so you can easily remember this. Next what we have is, so this question asks nylon 66 is so named because. So they have given four options. Now in order to select the correct one, I will first show you the diagram so you can easily relate to it. So this is the structure of nylon 66. So you can see that between the two nitrogen atoms there are 6 carbon atoms which are present. So clearly the correct option will be the number of carbon atoms between two nitrogen atoms are 6. This is the correct option, option B. So the next question is, so the catalytic converter for conversion of SO2 to SO3 by contact process should have a feed with SO2 content between. So the correct answer is 7 to 10%. So let's move on to the next question. So this one asks the composition of fresh feed to the high temperature and high pressure urea autoclave is. So excess liquid ammonia and liquid, this is not correct. Excess liquid ammonia and compressed CO2 gas. This is the correct option. The answer is excess liquid ammonia and compressed CO2 gas is the composition of the fresh feed to the high temperature and high pressure urea autoclave. This is the answer to this. Let's move on to the next question. So among the following, choose one that is not an exothermic process. So I have repeatedly said before, catalytic cracking is an endothermic process. So always remember this. They have repeated this question a number of times that catalytic cracking is an endothermic process. So this question asks the commonly used solvent in supercritical extraction is. The answer is carbon dioxide. This is the most common solvent for supercritical extraction. So this next question asks the average boiling point of aviation turbine fuel is closest to that of. The answer is kerosene. So as I am saying these answers, please make a note of all of these because revising this is what is important for the main exam. So this next question asks one of the steps during refining of cane sugar consists of addition of hydrated lime to the sugar syrup followed by carbonation of the resulting solution. The purpose of this step is to the options given are adjust the pH of the syrup. Well, this first option is correct. Is to adjust the pH of the syrup. Rest are incorrect. So remember this, that the steps during refining of cane sugar consist of addition of hydrated lime to the sugar syrup. So hydrated lime is added to the sugar syrup in order to adjust the pH of the syrup. So please make a note of this also. So this question was asked in GATE 2001. This was asked in GATE 2001. They are asking styrene is produced from ethyl benzene by the process of. So let's see this. Styrene looks somewhat like this. This is the structure of styrene. C double bonded CH2. This is styrene. And ethyl benzene is like this. This is ethyl benzene. CH2 CH3. This is ethyl benzene. So you can clearly see if I want to go from here to here, I need to remove one hydrogen atom from here and one hydrogen atom from here in order to get this double bond. So clearly what I am doing is I am removing hydrogen. So it is dehydrogenation. So this next question asks in the fluid catalytic cracking FCC, the cracking reaction is dash and the regeneration is dash. So remember that the catalytic cracking is endothermic. This is endothermic. And the regeneration is exothermic. The catalyst regeneration is exothermic. So the next question asks, in petroleum refining, the process used for conversion of hydrocarbons to aromatic is. So the process is catalytic reforming. Catalytic reforming is used for converting hydrocarbons into aromatics. So also keep a note that the catalytic reforming is done to increase the octane number. To increase the octane number. So this is an important point. You can keep a note of this. So this next question asks, commercially ethylene is produced from naphtha by. The answer is hydrocracking. Ethylene is produced from naphtha by hydrocracking. So this next question asks, triple superphosphate is manufactured by reacting. The answer is obvious, phosphate rock with phosphoric acid. So they have repeated the same question a number of times about triple superphosphate and single superphosphate. So remember, triple superphosphate is phosphoric acid plus phosphate rock. And for single superphosphate, it is sulfuric acid with phosphate rock. So please make a note of this, phosphate rock. So I have also made a separate video between triple superphosphate and single superphosphate. I will link it in the description or you can click the card. So next is the 50th question. So this next question is to match the following type. They are asking to match the equipment in group 1 with the process in group 2. So let's see fluidized bed. Fluidized bed is catalytic cracking. Multistage adiabatic reactor. This will be multistage adiabatic reactor with interstage cooling will be sulfur dioxide oxidation, SO2 oxidation. Ford Griner machine is for paper making and diaphragm cell is for sodium hydroxide. So let me write all of this, then it will be clear. Fluidized bed, let me number this 1, 2, 3, 4. So P, fluidized bed will be catalytic cracking, 4. And Q, multistage adiabatic reactor with interstage cooling, this will be SO2 oxidation, 3. Ford Griner machine, R will be 1, that is paper making. Ford Griner machine is paper making. And diaphragm cell is sodium hydroxide, S will be 2. So this is the correct selection. So let's move on to the next question now. So this previous question came for 2 marks. Please remember that this came for 2 marks. The previous questions which we were dealing with before this 50th question all were 1 mark. From this we are going to discuss 2 mark question and this came in GATE 2017. This was a 2 mark question. So this one is also a 2 mark question. The question says a catalytic reforming plant produces hydrogen and benzene from cyclohexane by dehydroaromatization. So let's break this down. A catalytic reforming plant produces hydrogen and benzene from cyclohexane by dehydroaromatization. So what does this mean? Let's write this reaction first. So I have cyclohexane. So from cyclohexane, they are producing benzene and 3 hydrogen. So because in cyclohexane, I have to remove the hydrogen in order to get this double bond. So this 3 hydrogen is being released. This is the first reaction, that a catalytic reforming plant produces hydrogen and benzene from cyclohexane by dehydroaromatization. So I don't need to focus too much on the process. I just need the stoichiometric equation. So this is the first equation that I have obtained. Second one, they say, in order to increase the production of hydrogen, the owner plans to change the process to steam reforming of the same feedstock that produces hydrogen and carbon dioxide. So the owner has changed from dehydroaromatization to steam reforming in order to increase the hydrogen production. So now let's see what will be the reaction for steam reforming. So if I do steam reforming, the reaction will be somewhat like this, the same feedstock, so there will be cyclohexane, but here we will need to give steam. So in the presence of steam, now we will get hydrogen and CO2. This will be the new reaction. So now the tough part is balancing this. It is not tough actually, if you look closely. So the first step is to balance the carbon. Here how many carbon atoms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbon, so give a 6 over here. So next step is, I have got 12 oxygen on this side. So I have to multiply a 12 over here. Now just balance the hydrogen. So here in each carbon I have two hydrogen atoms attached like this. Two hydrogen atoms attached like this. So how many hydrogen I get? 2, 6 and 12. So 12 over here, 12 hydrogen over here, 12 hydrogen from this, and from here I have 24 hydrogen. So total I have 36 hydrogen on this side. So here I need to make 36. So what I have to multiply over here? I have to multiply over here 18. So this is 18, this is 3. So our problem is solved, because they are asking what is the maximum ratio of pure hydrogen produced in the proposed process to that of the existing process. So maximum ratio is this 18 divided by 3. 18 divided by 3. So the answer is 6. 6 is the answer to this. In the options they have given, so these were the options for this problem. The correct answer is D6. So with this I end this video. We have solved many questions in this video. I don't want to make this video too long. So we will continue in the next video again. Thank you.